رمضان هل هلاله وظلاله.
الصلاة والسلام على رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Honorable viewers to ITV on the special edition of iSoul, the special edition of Soul Food. Subhanallah, hardships, trials, tribulations are Allah's way of transforming us and helping us develop spiritually if we choose and allow them to do so. Be it sabr in our personal life, illnesses, death, death of loved ones, problems, setbacks in life beyond our control. My honorable viewers, listen to the words of the Almighty in the Quran, Surah Taghabun, Surah 64, verse 12. Ma asaba min musiba. Whatever afflictions a believer encounters, illa bi idhni, but only it happens by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa may yu'min billah yahdi qalba. But when you bring your belief, your iman in Allah, then Allah guideth your heart. Wallahu bikulli shayin alim. For indeed, Allah has knowledge over everything. And Allah has knowledge over you right now, my honorable brother, my honorable sister. I repeat that verse. Whatever afflicts any believer of any setbacks in life, it only happens by the will of Allah. But when you connect your heart to Allah, you put your firm belief in Allah, then Allah guides that heart, because indeed Allah has knowledge over everything. The prophetic guidance teaches us, as-sabr nisful iman. Patience is half of your iman. Patience is half of your belief structure. Wal yakin al iman kullu. And to believe that may Allah will have the answer, may Allah will have the way out, that is complete iman. Count Allah's blessings, my honorable viewers. Count Allah's blessings upon you and not your problems. Fight that anxiety by praying. What a beautiful space and time you are in the month of Ramadan. My honorable viewers, let's set the reality straight. Life is short. Don't make it even shorter by worrying. In fact, there's an interesting book that's written, Stop Worrying and Start Living. The Quran mentions about 90 examples of patience, because the Prophet ﷺ said, وَمَا أُعْطِيَ أَحَدْ أَعْطَى خَيْرٌ وَأَوْسَعَ مِنَ الصَّبْرِ. A believer, there's no gift from the Almighty greater than having patience, subhanallah. It's known as, in the Quran, the three P's of life. Patience, perseverance, and prayer. One has to bow down and kneel down to the Almighty. In Surah Baqarah, the second surah of the Quran, verse 153, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu ista'inu bis-sabri was-salah. That, O believers, seek Allah's help with patience, perseverance, and prayer. Inna Allaha ma'as-sabirin. Surely you would find Allah with the one that is most patient. Wasn't Anbiya there also tested? Didn't this show us the secrets of secrets? Patience, perseverance, and prayer. Change comes with perseverance. Change comes with pressure. And we all are under pressure of some kind. Whether it is financial, whether it is work, marriage, relationships, etc. Trials test our iman, our faith, our belief. And it puts us under pressure. And what does this pressure produce? It produces perseverance. And what does that mean? Don't give up. وَمَنْ يُصَبِّرْ يُصَبِّرْهُ اللَّهُ. The Prophet ﷺ says that whoever shall remain patient and persevere, then Allah will make you patient and persevere. And in Surah Ali Imran, Allah says, وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الصَّابِرِينَ. Allah loves that one that is being tested, and you're encountering, you are persevering and having patience and prayer. Inna Allah yuhibbul mutawakkilin. Allah loves that one that puts his trust and her trust in the Almighty Allah. Therefore, honorable viewers to ITV, there are four things that are inseparable: shukr, sabr, tawakkul, and yaqeen. To show your gratitude from the depth of your heart, to bear patience when being tested, to put your ultimate trust completely in Allah, believing that Allah will have a way out, and having firm belief in your Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah grant us these four ingredients. How beautifully the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ajaban li amri al-mu'min." How beautiful is the life of a believer, provided you believe. Inna amrahu kullahu lahu khair. Everything in our daily lives is only meant good for us. When there is good moments, you fill your heart with gratitude. I'm too blessed to be stressed. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah for this day of Roza. Alhamdulillah, I'm fasting. Alhamdulillah, I brought 20 days through so beautifully. Alhamdulillah, I'm nearly finished with my Quran khatam. Alhamdulillah, all my grandchildren also fasting. Alhamdulillah, so beautifully to see the weekend. We all ate together with Bismillah. And we thanked Allah Ta'ala for all Allah Ta'ala's bountings for this month of Ramadan. وَإِنْ أَصَابَتُ دَرَّا. And when there come adversity, when there comes some test in our lives, we exercise patience. And that is also good for us. Because indeed the Almighty says in Surah Tawbah, كُلَّنْ يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا. That nothing afflicts any human being but that Allah has already decreed for us. هُوَ مَوْلَانَا. For indeed Allah is our protector. وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. And true believers, they put their complete trust in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear viewers, there are five things to give up. Number one, overthinking. Number two, fearing change. Number three, living in the past. Number four, negative self-talk. And number five, trying to please everyone. I want to tell you, my dear honorable viewer, right now, whilst you are watching this program, you are perfect exactly as you are. There is no need to change anything except thoughts that you aren't good enough. And the Almighty says, I am exactly by your way of thinking, and I am there when you kneel down and you lift your hands into prayer, patience, perseverance. People, when they find happiness, they find happiness when they find Allah. People understand life when they understand the Creator. People truly start living when they make Allah their guide. وَيَهْدِ اللَّهُ مَنْ يُنِيبُ. Allah says Allah guides the one that wants guidance. Once you learn that Allah is enough, you'll never have to question yourself. You'll never have to doubt yourself. You never have to doubt your decisions. فَإِذَا عَزَمْتَ فَتَوَكَّلْ. Whatever decision you have to make, you put your trust to Allah, and Allah suffices. When you put that connection to Allah, you will become whole again. You will become complete again. Because وَكَفَى بِاللَّهِ وَكِيلًا. Allah is the best one to rely on. Our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the seal of all prophets, he experienced hardships, difficulties as normal human beings. He felt ill, he experienced severe pain, he experienced hunger, he experienced thirst, he felt fatigue, tiredness, weakness of the body. His head was wounded at the Battle of Uhud. His feet was bloodied at Taif. And the calamities and the trials our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam underwent also serve as a consolation for the Ummah when we overcome adversities and tribulations. I end off, my dear viewers, exactly what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even in the month of Ramadan, he said, Ramadan huwa shahru sabr. This month is a month of patience. وَثَوَابُهُ صَبْرُ ثَوَابُهُ الْجَنَّةِ. And for this month of patience, its reward is Jannah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us these beautiful qualities of shukr, filling our hearts with gratitudes for this very month that Allah has blessed us to be connected with Allah. Idha salima Ramadan, salimatu sana. How you spend this month of Ramadan, your year will go well with you. And we thank Allah Ta'ala for that quality of sabr. As the Prophet ﷺ says, arba'un man utiya hunna faqad utiya khayra dunya wal akhirah. There are four gifts. If Allah has blessed you with these four, you have been blessed with the best of gifts in this life as well as the next. Qalbun shakir, a heart filled with gratitude. Badanun sabir alal bala, a body that exercises patience when Allah is in the making of testing you. Lisan dhakir, a tongue that is always in the remembrance of Allah. And what a better month. To him the praises of Allah, and also a pious companion. We make dua, Allah Ta'ala grant that the rest of the days of Ramadan, we find our answers in all our setbacks and realize it is only my Allah. Increase in La ilaha illallah. Increase in istighfar and ask for Allah. Bow down to Allah and believe my Allah is listening to that call. Wa ma tawfiq illa billah. Wa salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. رمضان هل هلاله وظلاله.